And up next is Star Wars The Clone Wars, and this is a computer animated feature that is leading into an animated series which will appear on Cartoon Network and TNT later this fall. And it pretty much feels like that. It's a very long advertisement for the TV show, and the plot takes place between episodes 2 and 3, so it's Anakin Skywalker before he's Darth Vader. And you know, I mean, beyond that, they're really, it's a cartoon. I mean, and the movie doesn't really ever feel much like a Star Wars movie. I mean, they mentioned the Force one time, and, you know, that almost none of the voice actors, or none of the actors from the live-action films provided their voices for this. It felt very much like a television production of Star Wars put on the big screen. And, you know, the animation was okay. And there certainly is a lot of action. This perhaps the most action I've seen in a 90 minutes of Star Wars. Mm-hmm. But at the expense of plot. I mean, and it just, it never really felt like a Star Wars movie. It felt like a throwaway Star Wars.
Yeah, it really did. I mean, it was probably, you know, a 45-minute cartoon episode stretched out into a feature-length film. And, you know, there's a lot of, you know, trekking through the desert. And I don't know if, I mean, it's obviously meant for kids being animated, but I don't know many kids that will be engaged by this for the full running length of this film. I mean, it drug on for a long time.
Well, and I mean, the live action Star Wars movies are more engaging.
Yeah.
I mean, whatever age group those happen to be aimed at, I mean, they appeal to everybody. And this one, I think, is aiming below the bar. It wasn't horrible. I mean, I didn't hate it.
No.
But I mean, for, you know, to put this into a movie theater, it was the wrong, I think, venue for this type of thing.
Maybe the wrong story. Maybe the wrong story even.
Yeah, it might play better in half-hour segments on TV, but yeah, just not the greatest of Star Wars movies. And it introduces the notion of a gay Hutt, which was a little odd because Jabba the Hutt plays sort of the object of interest in the movie, and they're trying, the Jedi are trying to make a deal with him, and then the bad guys are trying to make a deal with him, and his uncle or something is on Coruscant, and he's quite flamboyant, and speaks English, which is just strange, but anyway, if the true Star Wars fans, I'm sure we'll see this regardless, and I imagine it'll make plenty of money, but I hate to say I bemoan the lack of involvement by George Lucas. I mean, even the prequel trilogy was better than this. So, I mean, the Star Wars faithful will see it. I thought it was kind of a waste of time, and I hate to say that about Star Wars, but I just skipped.
And I don't, but I agree that you should skip it. And we'll be right back with our next review.